Who the hell are you? They bring you in to replace me? They're replacing me, aren't they? Ah, shit! Shit, man! I need this! Gotta pay the bills. And I'm addicted to a lot of different kinds of chems. I mean, a lot. Ha! You had me going for a second there. Then I remembered that there's only one Fantastic. I'm king of this dump.
I don't know why that failed, Chris. He's not necessary. You don't even talk to him at all. Actually, no, you get...
Who the hell are you? They bring you in to replace me? Worried? Do I look worried to you? I've got this under control, baby. No one else can do what I do here. Fuck, man. Everything. I push buttons, I turn dials, I read numbers. Sometimes I make up little stories in my head about what the numbers mean. Like one time I imagined they were a code to get into a vault full of naked women. Man, how cool would that be? Well, see, we're getting power because the guy running this place is fantastic. But the mirrors outside aren't aimed right, so we're running at 1% efficiency. And I guess that just isn't good enough for some assholes. Trouble is, most of the controls for this place aren't here. They're in the tower. And that place has some crazy pre-war security system that the dumb shit NCR set off when they took over. Killed two guys. Now they won't go near it. They want me to make an omelet, but I can't break any of their eggs. Know what I'm saying? There's these two terminals outside. They control the mirrors. I tried fooling with them, but didn't get very far. You'd have to get them to talk to the mainframe up in the tower, then do the rest from up there. I'm guessing, but it sounds good, right? Hey, you're not thinking about going up there, are you? Well, hey, if you find yourself up at the mainframe, do yourself a favor and make sure you send the power to the right place. It needs to go to the Strip and McCarran. Here, you'll want this. It's the password to one of the terminals outside. Found it written on one of the stalls in the bathroom.
It's unusual to see a new face here. Are you a soldier or a scientist? I see. Then you must have some special business here for them to have let you through. Interesting. Forgive me for prying, but I'm curious. Are you with a particular group? Then for everyone's sake, I hope you serve a worthy master. Are you a maker of war or peace? That's reassuring. Although many who've made that claim to the followers of the Apocalypse over the years have had less than pure intentions. But if it's really as you say, then take my advice. This installation carries with it dangers that no one here has realized. Take care of what you do here, and who you listen to. Some things are best left buried with the old world. Goodbye.
Thank you. Not my... Yeah, you and me both.
Can't run from me. All mine. Eat this.
There's nothing. Scanning for hostiles. Please clear.
Can't run from me. You're mine.
Yeah.
Hello there. It's good to see a friendly face. I almost took you for a raider, I did. Name's Malcolm. Malcolm Holmes. Don't suppose you'd care to trade. I'm missing a few essentials and... screw this. Lying just ain't in my nature. I'll tell it to you straight. I've been following you for a good bit now. It started off innocently enough. I was traveling, as I often do, and happened to observe you picking up one of those blue star caps. You didn't show any reaction to it, so I figured you didn't know what you'd gotten your hands on. There's an old wasteland legend that says somewhere out there is a fabulous treasure from before the war. Those caps with the blue star on them, the tale goes, are the key to that treasure. They're called Sunset Sarsaparilla Stars. Nah, I gave it up years ago. Too dangerous. And even if I did still collect them, I'd tell you the same. There's people out there so mad with the idea of treasure that they'll attack strangers just on the suspicion that they have some of those caps. Nope. Huh? You want to talk some more? Oh, that's right. Here, let me show you what I've got on hand. Huh? You want to...
What can I help you with?